motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a live edition of Flow of Wisdom Radio. Thank you so much for tuning in. I am Sean Anthony. My website is flowofwisdom.com. Man, I got so caught up in doing what I'm doing, I didn't get a chance to post it. The links on social media yet that I am live, but flowofwisdom.com will get you linked to all of my social media, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, etc. You know, listen, this show today is going to be the beginning of a series. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that each week thereafter is going to be a part two, part three, part four, and so on and so forth, you know, because I got other interviews and other things lined up for the show. But this show here is a part one of a series. And a few months ago, I received a call live here on the show, Floor Wisdom Radio, from a gentleman out of Texas, Austin to be exact, if I'm not mistaken. And this gentleman called not only once, but he called twice, reminding me, you know, because whatever I was talking about on the show, it may have alluded to some current event that was going on here in the U.S., and especially about the racial tension that's going on, the injustices against black people here in America, police brutality, so on and so forth. And this gentleman called up and was like, "Sean, what about the Boule?" He kept asking, "What about the Boule? Why aren't we asking, you know, the people in the Boule to speak up on the injustices of what's going on with black people in America?" That's what his question was. I'm paraphrasing what he was asking to me. We got to put these people to the fire, hold them accountable, or what have you. Now, for some of you maybe listening, you're like, "Boule, what is that? And I never heard of that. What are you talking about, Sean Anthony?" Well, that's what this show is going to be about. I'm going to be laying down some groundwork, some foundational information in regards to the Boule. Now, I am by far not the expert on the Boule. However, that's not going to say that I haven't done my research and looked into it, because I have. In fact, when that gentleman from Austin, Texas called in about the Boule, I immediately remembered my conversation with the late Steve Coakley, which I'm going to get into him in a little bit as well. Now, to kind of paraphrase it, for sake of, you know, just the introduction of who the Boule is. The Boule is a fraternity, if you will. Sigma Pi Phi is the actual name of this fraternity. Sigma Pi Phi. And, you know, I went after high school, I graduated and I went on to an HBCU, a historically black college university. I went to Central State University for 1 year. And when you have that experience as a young black man going to an HBCU, you get exposed to all of the black Greek organizations, the fraternities, the sororities. You know, you have the Alphas, the Omega Psi Phi's, the Kappas, the Iotas, and the Sigmas, and of course the sororities, the Deltas, the AKAs. What is the one? Sigma Gamma Rho, and all of these other organizations, these Black Greek organizations. You experience that on black colleges, college campuses. And it's quite an experience. And I've had an opportunity to really have some great relationships with some very, very good friends of mine that are a part of a lot of these black Greek organizations. Okay. Now, when you talk to these individuals, especially some of one of my closest friends, he's an alpha. Alpha is considered the first Black Greek organization. And they will boastfully, proudly tell you that. But upon doing research, they are not the first Black Greek organization. And in fact, is Sigma Pi Phi. Alpha Phi Alpha was established in 1906. And Sigma Pi Phi was established prior to that, which we're going to get into. Sigma Pi Phi fraternity is the first Black Greek organization, okay? And Sigma Pi Phi is also known as the Boule. Now, I'm going to get into the history of the Boule. And mind you, that's a lot of information that I'm going to cover for the next 2 hours. And please, by all means, feel free to call in, chime in. I'm going to take my time with this. I'm not going to try to rush this information. And because of the information, the great amount of information that I'm going to share, because it's so layered, we will take rabbit trails. Okay, we're going to go in many different directions because the information is so layered. Okay. And so with that being said, I will put the number out there, 877-300-7645. And if you are listening online, please, you know, if you're on social media, tweet me at Sean_Anthony or go to my Facebook page. Just let me know, you know, that you're listening. I haven't even had a chance. When I take a commercial break, I'm going to send some, you know, post it to my social media, you know, for people to chime in or whatever with your questions, your thoughts, your comments, even if you have some information to add to. But I will say, if you do have something to add to, just kind of bear with me because I may get to it. But nonetheless, it's an open conversation. We will be very phone interactive as well as social media. But real quick, I'm going to give you the history of the Boule from their own words, their own website. And this information is available, okay? And then I'm going to play excerpts of my interview with Steve Coakley, okay? Now, people may, before we even get into the history of the Boule, because after that, I'm going to play excerpts from my conversation with the late Steve Coakley. He passed away several years ago, okay? And to give you a background on who Steve Coakley is, and this is according to Wikipedia, he was an American political researcher and lecturer who lectured nationally on political and economic issues relating especially to the African American community. Steve Coakley was also, they called him a futurologist, who commented extensively on water conservation, organic farming, and communal living. Coakley gave over 5,000 lectures on the topic of global warming and corporate conspiracies, the Trilateral Commission, the Bilderberg Group, the Rothschilds, Rockefellers, Boule, etc. Coakley's research delved into the history of Marcus Garvey, the Black Panthers, and other areas of African American history. Steve Coakley lectured at many colleges, college campuses nationally, and was also known for his conspiracy theories involving the Black male elite organization known as the Sigma Pi Phi, also the Boule, is called the Boule, and the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. by the hands of Reverend Jesse Jackson and the CIA. Coakley was assistant to the Special Committee on Rules under Mayor Harold Washington. This is in his earlier years, ladies and gentlemen. He gained notoriety when he served as a special assistant to the former mayor of Chicago, Eugene Sawyer. So, giving you some background on Steve Coakley and a little bit more, he was criticized for teaching that Jewish doctors were using the AIDS virus in an attempted genocide against Africans. His comments created a nationally publicized controversy in 1988, and he was dismissed from his position as aide to Sawyer. When in 1990, Illinois Governor James Thompson signed an agreement to open an Israeli aircraft industries plant in Rockford, Coakley was outspoken, was an outspoken opponent. He argued that black leaders in Illinois should oppose Israeli war industries because of their military support for the apartheid systems in South Africa. So that's to give you a background on Steve Coakley when you hear my excerpts of my conversation with him several years ago before he passed. Now, mind you, just when I get to those excerpts, from my understanding, I think that my interview with Steve Coakley was like one of the last big platform public interviews that he did. Because after I interviewed him, it was not long after that that he passed. However, he did do some radio programs and some blog talk radio lectures. But as far as a bigger platform, from my understanding, my interview was one of the last interviews. So you're going to hear that coming up shortly. And when I come back from this break, I'm going to give you the history of the Boule. I am Sean Anthony. You are listening to Flow of Wisdom Radio. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in live here at Flow of Wisdom. I am your host, Sean Anthony. The website is flowofwisdom.com. My toll-free number is 1-877-300-7645. 877-300-7645. Today, we're talking about the Boule, the history of the Boule. Now, from their website, I will share with you the history of the Boule. And this is by their member, the grand historian, Rodney J. Reed. It reads, at the dawn of the 20th century, black men of distinction had long functioned in various leadership posts, especially in the churches and benevolent association movement. Some, notably Frederick Douglass among them, had even served in high government posts. But by and large, they lived lives separate from those of black masses and the white professionals. In 1904, a small group in Philadelphia set out to create an organization that would provide a vehicle for men of standing and like taste to come together to know the best of one another. Henry McKee Minton was the leading figure in the discussions about organizing a group for such purposes. Henry Minton was born in Columbia, South Carolina on Christmas Day in 1871. He went to the school at the Academy of Howard University and eventually Phillips Exeter Academy, from which he graduated in 1891. Minton studied law for a year and then went to pharmacy school at the Philadelphia College of Pharmacy, from which he graduated in 1895. He received his MD degree from Jefferson Medical College in 1906. Minton also spent considerable time contemplating the isolation in which accomplished black men lived and worked. He began to talk with other black professionals, Dr. Algernon B. Jackson being chief among them, about their shared conditions and about his ideas for forming an organization that would bring them together in fellowship. Minton thought that black learned and professional men should have an organization that, quote, should be a fraternity in the true sense of the word, one whose chief thought should not be to visit the sick and bury the dead, but to bind men of like qualities, tastes, and attainments into a close and sacred union that they might know the best of one another, end quote. Members would not be selected on the basis of brains alone, but in addition to congeniality, culture, and good fellowship, that they should have behind them an at initiation a record of accomplishment, not merely be men of promise and good education. His fraternity would contain the best of skull and bones of Yale and of Phi Beta Kappa. I'll repeat. His fraternity would contain the best of skull and bones of Yale and of Phi Beta Kappa. After months of conversation with Jackson and some discussions with Edwin C. Howard, MD, and Richard J. Warwick, both physicians, the four men met together at Howard's home on May 15, 1904. The men agreed that they would meet again in 2 weeks and recruited two other physicians, Robert J. Abell and Eugene T. Henson, to join their group. In their first constitution, the group proclaimed that, whereas it seems wise and good that men of ambition, refinement, and self-respect should seek the society of each other, both for the mutual benefit and to be an example of the higher type of manhood, be it resolved that a society be organized for the purpose of binding men of like qualities into a close, sacred, fraternal union, that they may know the best of one another, and that each in this life may to his full ability aid the other, and by concerted action bring about those things that seem best for all that cannot be accomplished by individual effort. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the foundation thus far on the history of the Boule. Toll-free number to call is 1-877-300-7645. We'll be back with more on this. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. 1-2. Check, check. 1-2. Yeah, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are live here, Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. And remember, we do this show live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Today, we're talking about the history of the Boule. Now, you got to be patient with me and go with me throughout this whole series, because it's laying the foundation to some stuff that's going to lead to some other things. And I told you, we're going to take different rabbit trails as I continue to share this information. And coming up here shortly in a few moments, I'm going to let you hear some excerpts of my interview with the late Steve Coakley. Just continuing on just a little bit on the history of the Boule, also Sigma Pi Phi fraternity, known as the Boule. They are the first Greek letter fraternity to be founded by African American men. Many people will tell you, many think that the Alphas, the Alpha Phi Alpha fraternity, they are the first. However, they are not. It is Sigma Pi Phi. The Alphas were established in 1906, okay? And as I stated in the last segment, Sigma Pi Phi was established in 1904. Okay, significantly unlike the other African American Greek letter organizations, its members already have received college and professional degrees at the time of their induction. The fraternity's insignia is the Sphinx. Now, I think that's interesting to know. That's interesting to know because all the other Greek organizations or black Greek organizations, you can pledge while you're in college, while you're working on your education. However, the criteria is different for Sigma Pi Phi. You have to already have some accomplished attributes already established. You have to be accomplished. You have to have your degree and your college and professional degrees at your induction. So, that's their process. From the beginning, Sigma Pi Phi fraternity was a learned society a social fraternity and an advancement organization, albeit a quiet one, because it's very quiet. Not many people know about the Boule. The fraternity believed absolutely in the equality of standing of its members and insisted that anyone who was eligible for membership was eligible and qualified for leadership. The founders were so certain of this fact that the fraternity elected its officers by lot, a custom that continued for most of the senior officer until 1970. But that's their history on their site on the Boule. Now, some people are like, you know, why are you talking about this? Again, this show is in response to the caller that I received on my show a few months ago. Was like, why aren't these members in the Boule speaking out about the injustices that's going on with blacks in America? Why aren't they? It's very I just gave you the foundation and their history. It's obvious that members of this organization, Sigma Pi Phi, or the Boule, these black men hold very prominent positions in America. A lot of them are your doctors, your lawyers, your financial chief financial officers, owners of corporations, sit on boards, judges. I mean, these are prominent people. Prominent black people in the United States. And, you know, they have a lot of influence. They have a lot of power. So the question is like, why aren't these people doing anything or speaking up, being vocal or whatever the case may be? And we'll eventually get to the answer to that as we continue to go on. But going back to what I was saying at the beginning of the show, I had an opportunity to interview Steve Coakley, the late Steve Coakley. And again, he passed away several years ago. And I don't even know when I remember when I found out it was I tried to do as much research. There was very little information that I could find on his death. Like it was like trying to find a needle in a haystack. It was just crazy. But Steve Coakley has been exposing information on the elite for many, many years, for decades, okay? For decades. In fact, he was the one that was on my show that told me that Google is the CIA. And he said this was prior, before this is, you know, mainstream information. Now, it came out, you know, several years later that the CIA and Google have been working together, you know, and trying to, I guess, fight terrorism or what have you, whatever the reason is. But nonetheless, Steve Coakley told me back then, which, you know, is telling me he already knew this information. So a lot of the things that he's been privy to, and he went around the entire country doing lectures, he's been speaking and exposing this information for quite some time. And it really questions, you know, how he died and why he died, because just a quick little rabbit trail. Prior to me having Steve Coakley on my show, we were in communication a year prior in advance, going back and forth and just talking to him and trying to set up an interview. We were trying to work on the times because he was on the West Coast. I'm out here on the East Coast. And he did not want to be pre-recorded. He wanted to be live because he just, you know, he just worked that way. But after we communicated, I lost contact with him. I didn't hear from him. He wasn't returning my calls like he normally would. And then I tried to reach out to him like a year later, and out of the blue, I talked to him and he told me he had been ill. He was very sick. So he had some health issues. I don't know the details, what was going on, but he did share with me that he had some health, some, you know, he was pretty bad off, whatever, but he had got himself up to where he was ready to do the interview. And that's what we ended up doing. So with all that being said, let's get into some of these clips here. The first clip, let me see. The first thing is, I'm going to read to you the Merriam-Webster definition of boule, okay? Because Steve Coakley is going to break it down for you. The definition of boule, according to Merriam-Webster, is a legislative council of ancient Greece consisting first of an aristocratic advisory body and later of a representative senate. Keyword, advisory body. Okay, just remember that. This first clip, this is when I asked Steve Coakley about the Illuminati. And this was his response when I asked him about the Illuminati. Listen.
Yeah, I tend to use the word Rhodes Rothschild secret society.
You said what, Rhodes Rothschild?
Rhodes. Rhodes as in Cecil Rhodes, and Rothschild as in Rothschild family of Europe.
Okay.
Those two white men formed a secret society in the late 1800s that still runs the world today. Now, I can trace Cecil Rhodes. He went to Africa. He stole diamond and gold with the cooperation of the Rothschild family and others. He named the country after himself, Rhodesia, that eventually in the revolution got changed to Zimbabwe. Now, they hate Robert Mugabe today because he did to the white invaders what the white invaders had done to our brothers and sisters in Africa, the land of Zimbabwe. And so Cecil Rhodes set up a secret society. Part of that society left money to train college-educated people at Oxford, including Bill Clinton, and Rothschild, who provided the finance for the society, split his family up around the major financial centers of Europe. If you were to look to the Trilateral Commission or the Bilderberger Group or the Council on Foreign Relations, you will find associates of the Rockefellers and Rothschilds and spread throughout the society to assure that the operators adhere to the agenda of the owners. So you can trace, quote, the founding of the State of Israel, for example, as a part of a strategy for a Jewish homeland that Rothschild in 1917 made Lord Balfour of the Foreign Secretary of England come up with a strategy. It didn't happen until they had to form a United Nations to make it so in the 1940s. So there were strategies of land, and that involved stealing the land of the Palestinians to put a settler population in place, now known as the Israelis. And you can follow that type of pattern. And, for example, if I talk about the Black Secret Society, Sigma Pi Phi.
Steve Coakley, is that the Boule?
Yes, it is, which means advisors to the king. You can see that it's a subsidiary. Its godfather is the Rhodes Rothschild Secret Society, or known as the Round Table Group. So every society has a father, just like you and I and the rest of us have fathers and mothers. That's necessary, no matter who or what you are. Now, let me just one more sidebar about the word Satan and evil. We are in a planet of which no one is perfect. I don't care who says what, whether it's us talking or whether it's the Catholic Church or the Pope or the head of the Episcopalians or the head of Islam. We are all vulnerable to error. Now, where else could there be a place where everyone is vulnerable to error and no one is perfect? So people walk around and they go, hello, not really recognizing in their anti-Satanism that they too stand in the pot of vulnerability. And the goal is to try to make sure that on a percentage basis that your existence is of value more to the good than it is to the evil. But all people on earth are vulnerable to error, or as they say, nobody's perfect.
Yes, yes, yes. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you are enjoying the show so far. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. And that previous excerpt from my interview with Steve Coakley several years ago, as you can see why I keep saying that this series is going to go many different directions. We're going to take many different rabbit trails. Just in that little 4-minute excerpt alone, the information that Steve Coakley shared, we can go numerous directions. In fact, that's why I gave you the definition of Boule before I played that excerpt, according to Merriam-Webster, because Steve Coakley's definition sums it up as the definition of Boule. He sums it up as advisors to the king. Now, there's another thing that he mentioned that we are going to expand on in the next hour, where he said the round table. But I'll get back into that beginning at the second hour here after the break. But right now we have a phone call, 877-300-7645. Robert in Chicago, you told my producer that you actually knew Steve Coakley. Robert, welcome to Floor of Wisdom.
What's up, Brother Sean? Thank you. Yes, and by the way, my brother, I've been listening to you for quite some time.
Okay, I appreciate it.
Like many of us in the research realm, and I've been researching since 1981, I don't know how many years that is, but I can assure you it's longer than Alex Jones, okay?
Yes, sir.
Who Brother Steve Coakley had enmity towards, because he appears to make himself the beginning of everything, and he's not. For instance, You mentioned Boule. That's the topic of discussion. Marcus Garvey was set up and removed by members of the Boule. The Boule actually goes back before the founding of the particular fraternity. They were the light-skinned black people who controlled the plantations and therefore the movements of blacks during slavery. So once slavery ended, they became prominent in the area of education, which many of them were ministers because the churches served as dual purposes in terms of schools and Masonic lodges, okay? Mm-hmm. So actually it goes back before the structure in the early part of the century in 1904. Mm-hmm. But Steve Coakley specifically broke down corporate structures and secret societies and how they influence these corporations. And so that you can see what's going on today has its roots in secret societies. But he also pointed out how the foundation influenced the lives of black people globally, and how through the use of the intelligence community, these foundations financed the overthrow of many governments. Okay, he revealed the Trilateral Commission, Council on Foreign Relations, Bohemian Grove, the Roundtable Group, and much, much more before it was mainstream. I know because we spent many years in the library doing the research, some of which we would give to Brother Steve, okay? He made many of us aware of what we know in the black community as the early warning system. That would be those community organizations that are financed by Ford, Rockefeller, John D., Catherine D., MacArthur Foundation, et cetera. He laid that thing out for us, and we went and did the research to be able to, so he could substantiate his argument. MK Ultra, MK Naomi, COINTELPRO, all of these things were part of our discussions in the 80s, where we would call into black radio and inform our people on what was going on. This is way before the internet. Mm-hmm. It's just so much, Sean. I'll wrap it up with this. We predicted 9/11 in 1994, and I have it on tape. We not only predicted what would happen, but we predicted what would happen as a result of it in terms of the Zionist control of the entire planet through the use of laws that they tried to put in place under Bill Clinton after Oklahoma City and couldn't do it. They put them back on the shelf and brought them down when they did a bigger bombing.
Wow. Robert, okay. can you hang on, Robert? We have to take a break, and I'm going to come back the second hour. Please don't hang up, Robert. I want to hear more from you. So if you could, just be patient. Stick around, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to continue this discussion and sharing this information on the Boule and the history of the Boule. And as I told you as a preface at the beginning of the show, we're going to take many different rabbit trails and directions because this information is so layered. Stick around 6 minutes past the top of the hour. I'm Sean Anthony. This is Flow of Wisdom.
Get motivated. Get motivated.